Jesus accepts our prayers. A biblical perspective. In the vast silence of our hearts, we whisper our prayers, seeking comfort and guidance. Ever wonder who hears these prayers? We turn to Scripture to show that it's Jesus, our loving Saviour, who accepts our prayers and worship. Look to the story of Stephen, a man of deep faith, who, while facing his death, directed his prayers to Jesus. His last words were, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit," a powerful testament of his unwavering trust in Jesus' divinity. Further proof is found in the Acts of the Apostles. The Apostle Paul, despite being a strict Jew, prayed directly to Jesus. He boldly asked, "Who are you, Lord?" And the answer came, "I am Jesus." Another testament comes from the Apostle Thomas, known for his skepticism. Upon touching the wounds of resurrected Jesus, he proclaimed, "My Lord and my God." This was not mere exclamation. It was a direct address to Jesus, acknowledging his divinity. Remember how Jesus himself taught us to pray. He said, "Whatever you ask in my name, that will I do." In my name signifies the authority and power of Jesus, inviting us to communicate directly to him. We also have the Apostle John's visions. In Revelation, we see creatures and elders falling before the Lamb, singing a new song. This shows Jesus being worshipped in heaven, further supporting the notion of Jesus' divine nature. Jesus didn't reject worship from his disciples. When they saw him walking on water, they worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Jesus accepted their worship, reinforcing his divine status. Jesus was also worshipped after his resurrection. The women who witnessed his resurrection fell at his feet, worshipping him. Jesus didn't rebuke them, but accepted their adoration, asserting his divinity. For those who doubt Jesus' divinity, let's visit John 1:1. "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Jesus is the Word made flesh, and thus he is God. Consider the confession of the Roman centurion at the crucifixion. Struck by the events, he proclaimed, "Truly this man was the Son of God." This recognition of Jesus' divinity came from a non-believer. In Philippians, we learn that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth, and under the earth, acknowledging Jesus' divine stature. It is clear, he is worthy of our worship and prayers. We see Jesus and God interchangeably addressed throughout the New Testament. Both receive prayers, both offer comfort and guidance, reinforcing the belief in the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. In the book of Romans, Paul speaks of calling on the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This, too, is a form of prayer directly addressed to Jesus. Once again, we see Jesus' divinity recognized and revered. In Corinthians, Paul ends his letter with a prayer to Jesus, "May the grace of the Lord Jesus be with you." This shows that the early church recognized and revered Jesus as divine, praying directly to him. In Hebrews, Jesus is described as our high priest. He understands our weaknesses, having faced the same testings we do. This makes him the perfect intercessor, bridging the gap between us and God with our prayers. In conclusion, Scripture provides ample evidence that Jesus accepts our prayers and worship. He is more than a prophet or teacher. Jesus is divine, the Son of God, our Savior. So, when we pray to Jesus.